Humans have been melting metals for 8,000 years. Why do you think human history is often divided into the Stone Age, the Bronze Age, and the Iron Age? Because melting metals had a big impact on human civilization. These periods were defined by the various tools, weapons, and building materials that shaped our development. But as curious and constantly evolving humans, we are challenged with creating new energy sources. One way could be to replicate on Earth that which powers our sun, the process of nuclear fusion. But to build fusion reactors, we need to have materials able to withstand extreme conditions, like temperatures of a few hundred millions of degrees Fahrenheit. Understanding how materials behave in extreme environments could also help us build modern nuclear fission reactors, prepare us for space missions, or even help us better protect ourselves from potentially DNA-damaging radiation, such as cosmic rays. Scientists here at SLAC National Accelerator Laboratory, using ultrafast electron diffraction, or UED, have developed a new understanding of materials in extreme environments. In UED, a very powerful electron beam examines the atomic structure of materials and tracks how atomic nuclei jiggle around. In the recent study, they looked at the melting of gold that was rapidly heated with a laser pulse and discovered atomic details that no one has ever seen before. They've discovered that the melting starts at the surfaces of nano-sized grains in the solid sample, forming pockets of liquid surrounded by solid gold. These pockets evolve over time until the entire sample becomes a liquid. Siegfried Glinzer, head of SLAC's High Energy Density Science Division, along with a team of postdoctoral scientists, Im Mo and Zi Chen, perform the experiments at UED. Siegfried Glinzer says this is only the beginning, as they can use this method to closely examine the melting properties of any material. This could help design and test future materials for applications that involve extreme conditions. In the case of nuclear fusion, this could one day be an important step to designing materials needed to solve the world's energy problems.